going, everybody? It is a Wednesday afternoon at 4:20 in May, which means that it's a Wednesday in May Backline fundraiser day here. I just want to thank everybody who donated last week. We kind of obliterated our monthly goal in a day, which is really humbling and amazing. And so we're now halfway to our new goal for the month. So I just want to thank everybody who donated, and also, you know, if there's anybody out there that wants to contribute to the fund, it is Mental Health Awareness Month, and I'm raising money for Backline, which provides assistance to musicians and crew members and managers and people in the music industry whose lives were tough even before coronavirus, but are now challenging in a new way. If you have the means and want to help out, I'm also announcing today, right now, that for those that do contribute, you will be given a ticket to a special event that we will do the first week of June to celebrate my birthday. We'll be doing like a live performance and Q&A with Backline on Zoom. And so everyone who contributed gets a ticket to this event. And those who contributed $100 or more get a VIP ticket, which is, a hang with me for a half hour, an hour or so before the event to hang out, have a birthday beer or something. So thank you to everybody, and really stoked to have my good friends, Alex Koford and Ross James, standing by, and I'm going to chat with them after playing a couple songs. So I'll just get to the music, and then we'll get with them. So I'm going to do a song that Susan Tedeschi and I used to play 20 years ago, and it's called Blues on a Holiday, written by Paul Rochelle. And I'm going to use this loop pedal here to set up the tune, and then that way I can solo over it. At this bar, wondering where you are. You know I'd be with you if I could. Honey, we should be together. No matter what you might say, come back and see just what you mean to me. put these blues on a holiday. Every time we get together, something turns out wrong. Now I've found peace of mind just by sitting here all alone. Honey, please come home. Everybody knows the reason, and everybody knows the score. Come back and see just what you mean to me. No one could ever love you. Something turns out wrong. Now I've found peace of mind just by sitting here all alone. Honey, please come home. Why won't you surrender? Consider everything I got to say. Why must we fight? Let's make love tonight and put these blues on a holiday. We'll put these blues on a holiday. Yeah. All right. Blues on a holiday. We'll do one more and get the cats in here. Hang out. All right. Once more with the loop pedal. This is a song by John McLaughlin and the Mahavishnu Orchestra. And I'm
gonna give it my best shot. Thank you.
Thing back on, and I should be over with my homies. Are you there?
Yeah.
Yo. Nice birds of fire.
Well, thank you. Hey, Wolfie. Oh, Wolfie.
Be polite.
Hey, man. That's good. It was really good to see you guys. Thanks for dropping by the show.
Thank you, man. It's good to see you.
I miss you guys a lot.
We miss you.
Same.
No doubt.
I miss you guys even before coronavirus. I miss you guys. You both have moved away from the Bay Area recently. Koff, you're down in LA.
Yep.
And Ross, are you in downtown Denver? Or?
Yeah, not far from downtown. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now we formed a triangle of compassion and love. And we'll find each other again. Well, we should call this the Bermuda Triangle.
I like it.
Yeah.
It's good. Yeah. I feel lost.
Very lost.
Yeah, I think we're all feeling a bit lost.
No bearings.
No bearings.
I just meant in the current moment, not in general.
Oh.
Yeah. I feel like I'm on the right track just right now. It feels lost.
Ross, you've been staying pretty active. You've got your podcast. Tell us about that.
Yeah. It's called Songs That Saved Me. And it's an idea I've had, you know, for a while. And this sort of pause in the way things were has allowed me the time to really focus on it in a new way. And it's also been a really fun project to do. So I'm pretty excited about it. One with Marcus King just came out yesterday. And then, you know, there's lots of cool ones coming up. One with the Eric from the Fruit Bats, Schofield's doing one, Andy Frasco, all kinds of stuff coming down the pike.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, man.
And you've been, and you did a, did you do a lot? Have you been doing like live streams from your backyard or stuff like that? Or,
well, I've been doing, you know, the occasional just live stream on Facebook and Instagram or whatever. And then I've also been doing some of the stuff on Live From Out There, which is a cool, sort of online festival that's been happening. That's had a lot of great music. A lot of people from our immediate family and, you know, extended family as well too, with lots of different kinds of artists. Some of the guys from Dawes have been a part of it, and
yeah, that's cool. They've
been regulars. Yeah.
My dad told me about that today. Cause he's, you know, he's all over, you know, the internet. And
I've been wanting to know what it is. I've been seeing a lot of it.
He was like, he's like, I saw this big festival, and he's like, your name isn't on there. He's like, what? They didn't ask you to do it. Thanks, Dad. I was like, you know, I don't get asked to do everything. It's, you know, I am.
How is Herman?
Oh, he's doing great. He's doing great. You know, they get outside, and you know, they're trying to find new places to walk. They've just been walking on the property because they don't, you know.
Yeah.
But I was talking with my mom today, and they're trying to figure out some quiet places where they can do their walks outside of their property.
Yeah, man. Tell them hi.
I will. I'm sure they're watching right now. They're regular listeners. So it was a lot of fun doing this video that we got to do over the last couple of days. This is the first time I think that you guys have done a cappella, right?
Yeah.
It's kind of a fun thing to do, to, you know, before the stream, when we were testing this, you know, the three of us were talking, or Ross was saying to us how, you know, you got to play with some people on your, like, you know, outside from a safe distance, and
yeah,
you know, how good it felt to play with a couple friends again.
Yeah.
And you know, obviously I miss playing with you guys so much, but it felt like working on that app. Even when I, you know, like in between takes, I would, you know, have the screen with, like, you know, four Kofords and a Ross, and I felt like, you know, like,
yeah,
we're kind of in the same room together, kind of like now, but even, you know, even less as much, because we weren't actually there. But right. It was fun. It was fun playing with you guys.
No doubt.
And working on that. So Patrick, when you're ready, why don't we roll out that a cappella video, and then we'll chat with these guys some more when that's done.
I want to tell you, my head is filled with things to say.
I'm watching it over here, but it's delayed.
Yeah, that was so much fun, man. I love the ending of that.
Taking out the trash.
So welcome to our new friend of the show, Arguments. How are you doing?
Friend of a friend of a friend.
Friend of a friend of the friend of the devil.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm,
yeah, good.
Happy to be here.
Thank you for cross streaming these shows on Wednesday for Backline. That, you know, that it really is meaningful to us to have that extra reach, and thank you for just for what you've been doing lately, hosting all of these musicians on your Deadheadland. Well,
Yeah, my pleasure on all of it. I mean, I was really touched hearing you talk about Backline in your first show, and I was happy to say, hey, let me help with this, you know, let me put this out. So Wednesdays at 4:20, you'll be here on Deadhead Land as well as all the other channels getting this message out and some good music. And I've been having so much fun expanding what Deadhead Land's been doing and scheduling live streams, and happy to have all of you on. I mean, you know, it's been a pleasure just listening to you, and the fact that I've had the chance to share it with other people and bring it to people who are stuck at home. It's I think it's a real good win-win on all fronts. So thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
So Koford, tell us about some of your, you have some new music, correct?
Well, I mean, the quarantine's been like a writing workshop. So, I mean, I guess I've recorded some demos, what I normally do to send to my band. But I've had a little extra time to put love into it. And so I'm considering about releasing maybe a handful of tunes that have been written in the last 2 months and recorded entirely in my apartment. So I feel pretty confident that that's something I'll do, but I've got a little bit of work left.
Well, we look forward to hearing it, man.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. I love your writing and your singing, man. You're a talented dude.
Thanks, man. Well, it's the Terrapin experience has been a huge blessing to be able to meet and be around musicians like you and Ross even, and like the amount of music that Ross has kind of passed down to me has been immensely helpful, and I feel like it's turned me into a different person and musician, and I'm really grateful.
Right on, man. Yeah, it's been
awesome. I have to say,
go ahead, Bri.
I've been digging up some clips of you guys recently, and I've been seeing a lot of stuff that I've recorded over the years, and it's really amazing to see first the breadth of material that you've done and how much all of you have developed really over the years and as players and playing with each other. So that's kind of my pleasure, having so much stuff archived that I get to see all of that. You know,
yeah.
I'll share it. It's
we've had a lot of different looks, just like the way we look has changed a lot over the 7 years we've known each other. When I look back,
oh, that too.
Yeah, I miss my cross-eyed phase. It was awesome.
I had like a big old bushy beard, not Ross level.
Right. Yeah, I remember the Cribs beard.
No,
I was a cowboy for a little while.
Yeah, you had the cowboy thing going on for a bit.
You'll always be a cowboy.
Yeah, where's the hat? Break out the hat.
Do the people know that my introduction to playing music at Terrapin and with Ross and everyone is through Ross's cowboy boots?
That's true.
Okay.
I don't know how, but American Jubilee was recording an album, self-recording. Yeah, self-recording and just like the first bit of music that was written by Brian and Ross. And we were out at
sponsored by this beer, right?
It was. We were. I don't know.
We actually were. Yeah. Koford didn't get any of it, but we were.
And crazy, not me.
But I put on Ross's smelly little sweaty cowboy boots, and I stomped around
on a wooden coffee table.
Yeah.
And it's on the record. Yeah.
It's a little reverb on there.
Yeah.
You guys want to know the secret? It's reverb.
I thought the secret was Bebop.
What was that, Jason?
I thought that the secret was Bebop.
They executed.
How long till Ross is really annoyed with Bebop?
Oh, we passed that before the show started.
Yeah, that's right.
I see that you're
Ross was like, okay, great, we're back in the van.
Well, that's what it felt like, man.
My favorite Bebop moment with you, Ross, is at Terrapin when you dared me to play Bebop through the soundboard.
Right. What gig was that?
I don't know. I don't think it was your gig, but
it was somebody else's gig.
Somebody else's gig, and you were like, please play Bebot through the soundboard. And I was like, no way am I doing that. And then a couple drinks later, I was like, okay, I'm doing this.
Yeah, that was good.
Andrew Erickson had a cable for me, and I was like, just put it through Ross's monitor. And you were taking a solo, and like once you had like a little pause in your solo, I was like, the rest of the band was like, where is that coming? Because it's coming out of the wedge, and it was coming out of the PA. It was great.
So good.
How many times did that sound come out of your fingertips?
Whose fingertips?
Yours. I know that there have been rainbows and laser beams shooting out of your fingertips. And
sure, yeah.
I'm wondering how many.
Rainbows are usually silent rainbows that shoot out of my fingertips.
Well, only you're seeing them.
Right. But I'm not hearing them, just seeing them, you know.
Did Bebop ever show up?
Not for a long time. Okay. Not for a long time.
Maybe we should try to do a latency jam.
Speaking of rainbows shooting out of my fingers.
Exactly. But before we do that, why don't we have Patrick roll this clip that Brian sent us today. It's trimmed down because it was like 12 minutes long. So we're going to just play like 2 minutes of this Eyes of the World from Terrapin. Brian, do you know when that was from? Like, did you know the date of that?
I think it was August 29th, 2014, I believe. And the band, it was Phil Esch and Friends, and included the three of you, and Lebo, and Scott Law. And right. I don't know what the specific for the show was, but.
Well, I picked these 2 minutes of the 11, you know, partly because it had like, you know, Ross and I and Koford kind of we were in the camera angle in, and also because you kind of put the camera on the crowd for a little bit, and it just made me feel good in that moment to just see some of those Terrapin regulars, audience members dancing. I'm so used to seeing that and or just seeing people in general in venues, and it's just something that we don't see anymore. And it made me smile. So it was nice to have a little crowd in there. So Patrick, why don't you roll this video, and then we'll come back and we'll try to do some esoteric jamming. Cool. That was kind of, Alex, what were you saying while we were watching it? You were saying it was a peppy version.
It was very peppy, yeah. That's all I got. It was fun to see. Jay Cross.
What's that?
Lebo, Scott Law, Jay Cross. That's good company. That's the good shit.
No doubt.
All right, let's do some psychedelic quarantine blues.
Are you ready, Kearns?
Boy, am I. I wake up in the morning. I brush my teeth. I'm gonna get my arms and legs in. 'Cause I'm on quarantine. I'm going quarantine. Everybody, don't you go getting into your cabinets and drinking your booze, 'cause you're quarantine blues.
Come on, Ross.
I thought we were over.
Yes.
Yeah, that happened. That's not, it's kind of like regular playing with you.
It was better than
you know,
the best I ever sounded.
The first time we've actually gotten to jam. Yeah. Beautiful.
Remember when I would play trumpet with you guys?
I remember one time you played trumpet.
Didn't you play it on that? Whatever that line is.
But I never did. Like, I might have brought the trumpet to Terrapin and then chickened out because I thought Phil was going to give me a.
What is that song?
Born Cross-Eyed.
Yeah, right.
Phil played trumpet on that section. That,
right, and I remember that part. I remember that much.
Beg for forgiveness, you know?
That's all we can do.
Well, this has been a ton of fun. I know, Ross, you got to get going soon.
It's so fun hanging with you guys.
Yeah, this has really been great.
Awesome what you're doing, Crosby. Really, really rad to see. Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thanks, man. Absolutely. You know, I'm just trying to, like, I don't know, feel a little bit more normal. You know what I mean? Like, just have some sort of sense of connection with all of you guys, and, like, you know, rather than like playing the same 100 songs over and over. You know, like, I want to connect with my people. You know. And then if I only play 4 songs, then I can rotate those 100 songs over a way longer period of time.
Totally. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm just using you guys so I can play less songs.
What's new?
What's new? Yeah. No, I love you guys so much. And thank you for supporting this, you know, for Backline. I checked during the break and I saw the fundraisers is approaching $3,000 now,
man,
which is amazing. You know, we're trying to get to 5,000 by the end of the month. So thank you everybody who has donated and, you know, brought attention to Backline. Because I think, you know, what they're doing is really important. I mean, we were all friends of Neil's and close with him, and, like, you know, like, hopefully Backline can help, you know, in situations when there's people like Neil who are going through things and not necessarily talking to us about it or other people about it, and can, you know, find a way to get help. You know, it's just, I know
it's a good thing to do.
It is. And, you know, anyway, I know we've been keeping it light today, but, you know, it is Mental Healthness Awareness Month. And what's that?
It's mental Healthness Awareness?
Mental Health Awareness Month. Did you know that? Mental Health Awareness.
May is just the awareness month. I mean, it's like Nurses Week, it's Mental Health Awareness, it's how many other things?
Cinco de Mayo.
I think all of these things should be daily things, you know.
Yeah.
People draw attention on certain days, you know. I mean, like, should Mother's Day be the only day you call your mom? Probably not. No. You know, like, should the month of May be the only day that you should check in with your friends and make sure that they're doing okay? Then, you know, probably not. So, but anyway, so thank you guys so much.
And thank you.
I look forward to seeing you again on a future FaceTime. And you're welcome to drop by anytime.
Right here.
whenever
and
you
vice want. Versa. Thank you for having me, and great to see you guys.
Yeah. Thank you, Brian. Well, all right. I'm going to say goodbye, and I'll play the audience off with a couple of songs.
Later.
Love see you, Jason. Bye, Brian. Bye, Ross.
Yeah. Yes.
Let me mute this. I could just do that. Oh, wait. We don't want to do that. There we go. Well, all right. That was a lot of fun. And thank you again to Alex and Ross and Brian at Deadhead Land for joining me here. I'm gonna play a couple songs that don't require the loop pedal. Pull up some lyrics.
People you're with, they're all scared.
staring still, and I wanted to be your good friend. Searchlights on the sky, I'm just looking for a friend who's gonna love my baby when she's gone around the bend. Egyptian bells are ringing when it's her birthday. Nothing I'm talking about you, it's a hurricane blowing your way. Ooh, such a beautiful way to break your heart. Ooh, such a beautiful way to break your heart. Some would call it a name. It's driving you insane. You were wearing that stained raincoat. Umbrella was a tangled mess. You were washed out on the glittery shores, looking for another crime to confess. You brought yourself out of a place in the sun, but you had some change to spend. You said you're gonna spend it on me, and shook the blues right out of your head. Such a beautiful way to break your heart. Ooh, such a beautiful way to break your heart. Ba, ba, ba. Someone calling your name. You're gonna miss that train. Such a beautiful way. Ooh, such a beautiful way. All right. That was It's All in Your Mind, followed by Beautiful Way, both by Beck. I'm gonna do a song of mine. Insane. the same. For it's strange you light the pain, you light the way, you've changed, it's insane, it's not the same, it's strange. That's Umbrella, that's off of Cryptologic. That tune actually, before there were lyrics and other parts, it was, it used to be called a song called D-Tune, and because it was in D, and it was a tune, and me and my brother, and Billy Titus, and Paul Dooley, and Dave Diamond, we recorded it, and we had all detuned our instruments in the middle of the song, and we just was like, there's this tune in D, and we had, it was just like the melody, and we were like, let's record this melody while we were in the studio recording about 15 other songs, and that's how it was named, D-Tune, D apostrophe tune, but then it became Umbrella. All right, well, I'm gonna do one more, and this is a song I've been really getting into lately off of the Song Reader. It wasn't one that I really covered a lot or played a lot when I first discovered or when Song Reader first came out in 2012. This was kind of like the single of that project, if you will. It was like the first one that I think that got released, and I kind of skimmed past it, and now I'm kind of into it. So I've been playing it a lot, and it gives me a chance to play the ukulele. So actually, you know what? I think I'm gonna loop it. Give it a little backbone with this acoustic guitar. Make sure all these other loops are erased. Just want to thank Alex and Ross and Brian for joining. And to Deadhead Lands and for cross-posting. And as always, to Howling Moon Studios and the Moonalice DDS tribe for hosting this daily content, which is pretty amazing to that, you know, to have these daily live streams, and Patrick down in San Diego helping us make it all happen from a technical standpoint is huge. Couldn't really do it without him. And you know, hopefully this is a nice daily distraction for some people, because the world is doing its thing. All right, here's Old Shanghai. Let's see if I can do this. See if I got lucky. And that was the right form. When you're walking in old Shanghai, mountains under the night sky, see the moon begin to rise, just like it did back home. Old men smoking in cafes, junk boats floating on the bay. Think of me while you're away in old Shanghai. With no ties, with no plans, your last dollar in your hand. Sell a ticket and send it back to someone you used to know. Things will always find their way from the back roads to the bay. Think of me while you're away. In old Shanghai. Shanghai, mountains under the night. night sky. See the moon begin to rise, just like it did back home. Lucky with that form. But those loops are kind of hard to plan ahead sometimes, and I've never really written down the best way to do it. I just try to memorize it, and so when I pick a song like that wasn't planned, it's always an adventure. But that one worked out well, and I'm grateful for it because it's the end of the show. So anyway, thank you everybody, and I hope everyone is sheltered in place safely, and taking care of their essential worker friends and healthcare worker friends, and staying safe. Everybody stay safe and stay in touch. All right, much love. Take care.